Congress shall make no law respecting the establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof or abridging the freedom of speech or of the press or the right of the people to freely assemble and petition the government for a redress of their grievances. It's the First Amendment. It's all that matters.
Welcome to another edition of the Rick Castellano Show, folks. Castellano's mighty happy. Excuse me a second. Age to perfection. Wait a minute. This is a big celebration. Scrumpelyumptious. Thank you, great granny. Diet ginger ale always comes in handy to wet the palate and to celebrate. Verdict in. The major part of the Arizona law that Eric Holder tried to sue Arizona for. The justices voted unanimously to uphold it. How you doing, Holder? You're going to be in contempt of court later this week? Every time you sue, you lose. You're on the wrong side of history. You and Dumbo. So, folks, Castellano's not going to just drink and gloat. I'm going to drink, though. Excuse me a second. In case you folks don't understand what's going on here with Arizona, Arizona only wants to enforce their borders. We have a gentleman, farm owner, landowner, that had illegal aliens cross into his backyard. And what happens? They killed him. So Arizona want to get a little stricter, and they want to enforce our borders. But the Obama administration, Eric Holder, why, if we enforce the borders, we won't get the Latino vote because nobody will vote for us because our ideals are terrible. The economy's terrible. But we don't enforce the borders. We get the illegal aliens to vote for us. You know why? They don't need ID. If you want to see Michelle Obama, you want to go visit her at a book signing or something like that, you need 10 forms of ID. But you want to go vote for the president or some councilman? You don't need an ID. You want to go to Blockbuster and rent a movie? You need an ID. You want to go to the library to get a library book? You need an ID. You want to buy cigarettes? You need an ID. Oh, wait. Let's talk about the administration and how backwards it is, how backwards the way it's thinking. Your little son or daughter, They got a headache and they need an aspirin. Guess what, folks? You need parents' permission to do that. But little Cindy Q Who or Cindy Q Lou, whatever the girl's name was from the Grinch, if she wants to get birth control, nobody needs to know. What me worry? Hey, birth control for all. You need birth control? Oh, you're dangerous. I can stop this. You could, maybe your period will disappear. Fine. Business as usual for the Obama administration. But if you need an aspirin, God forbid, an aspirin? We need all kinds of IDs. Let's get back to where we are. This administration is on the wrong side of everything. Which brings us to the Arizona border. We want to protect our borders. Any country in the world protects their borders. If you're here illegally, you have to show your papers. Otherwise, they arrest you. Not in the good old U.S. way with Dumbo and company and Savoir Fair, that 50-cent mustache. Because in our country, if you could vote for us legally, Mickey Mouse voting last election, if we could get a vote, because, like I said, we're losers, and the only way we could get votes is we got to get them illegally, it's okay. Come one, come all. Hey, am I saying that all illegal aliens are bad people? Well, they're breaking our law, first of all. We're a nation of laws. But No, they're not all evil people, but you know what? There's some of them that are rapists, that are murdering people. Some of them are driving without license, DWI killing people. Some people are selling drugs, a lot of them. But no, what me worry?
Well, Obama administration or potential voters down the line.
Besides, you folks, you heard it on the Castellano show first. President Obama, whether he wins or loses his election, guess what he wants to be? He wants to be the head of the UN because he wants to be the president of the world. Well, listen, Dumbo, it's got to stop now. You lost immigration. You lost in the Arizona thing. Hopefully this Thursday, healthcare will be struck down. The thing that everybody needed jobs, but you had to push this through. 2,700 pages that nobody read, not even the justices. You had to push through. I hope it gets struck down. Everything you do, everything you touch turns to dust. You're watching the Rick Castellano show. Tune in each and every week. You get plenty of me. And if you don't like it, maybe you like Great Granny's Diet Ginger. I'll help you wash it down. I need a little right now. I'm drinking this to myself. And then in a second, I'm going to tell you who Castellano hates and despises. Not me. Eric Holder, I despise you. I loathe you. What are you doing, Mr. Holder? Black Panthers, Philadelphia, they disrupt the voting, threaten old white men, old white women, saying you better vote for President Obama or Senator Obama at the time, otherwise we'll beat you with this billy club. Should we prosecute them? No, they're black. Can't do that. Mr. Holder, Fast and the Furious operation that you were in charge of.
I don't know nothing about it. Oh, I didn't know anyway. Well, I'll look into it.
You still don't know what's going on. At least that's what you say. I take the fifth. We have a border control agent, Mr. Terry, dead. Why? Because your little political games. Dead, Fast and the Furious. You don't want to hand in any information. You want to continuously lie. You want to continuously sit there and act, I'm savoir-faire everywhere. No, you're a liar. People know you're a liar. You sit there and Mr. Issa lambasted you like he should because it was so easy that you were trying to avoid the truth. You're the head of trying to keep us secure, but what do? You're doing everything but keep us secure. So you know what, Mr. Holder? Folks, if anything happens to me, like Castellano with the TSA when they checked me every time I get boarded the plane for a while until I came on the show and I talked about it, if anything happens to me, okay, and it looks like a coincidence, it probably isn't. Probably Mr. Holder will probably do something because you know what? I tell it like it is. Mr. Holder is a criminal. Mr. Holder, in the Clinton administration, let criminals off. Murderers. Racketeers. Okay, he's an old-time Chicago gangster. And he's a criminal and he's a liar. And I despise him. Watch the news. He's one of the worst. Who else does Castellano despise? John, I pay $400 for my haircut, Edwards.
It's not mine. It's not my baby. It's my interns. It's, oh, yeah, I would never do that. I wouldn't be president. I'm good.
I'm an ambulance chaser. Would you? What are you, John Edwards? You're an ambulance chaser. Every dollar you got. You didn't make any good laws for Congress. You didn't do anything good. You were an ambulance chaser. What did you do? You sued. You're like the Rainbow Coalition. What do? You go over and sue people to get money. Oh, there's not enough black people and Budweiser in race cars, so we're gonna sue Budweiser or not enough of this. You're an ambulance chaser. What do is you go against big organizations and you sue them, and it's cheaper to settle with you than to fight it. So you're a loser with your $400 haircuts and
I loves my...
No, you're just Southern guy. I wish I could make fun of you. I could say it, but I can't talk like a Richard Simmons lookalike than you really are. Richard Simmons has got more coyones than you do. You goof! Let me tell you something.
It's not mine.
Oh. All of a sudden on TV the other day, you get found not guilty because you get a couple of bleeding heart liberals that They can't prove it out of a shadow of a doubt that this old 103-year-old lady gave you $1 million to get rid of this kid.
I love my Quentin more than anything in the world. I love her.
If you love her so much, why didn't you take claim of her right away? If you love her so much, when the thing first happened, you said, you know what? I still want to be a president, but I made a mistake. I'm married. I should have been divorced, but I love this girl. No. What'd you do? You lied to the country because you cared more about yourself. You let this girl that you had a baby with, it's a pig, by the way, because she knew you were married and your wife had cancer, but she was banging you. Why? Because she lost the prestige of being around a loser like you. A loser.
Well, I'm banging John Edwards. He's got a wife, but I'm going to get half of whatever he's got.
Yeah, you're a loser. Your wife had cancer, and you're screwing around with one of your interns. What are you going to do? I'm going to give her a $100,000 a year job. She doesn't know how to use a camera. I want to make her a camera. $100,000 a year. I get some 103-year-old white lady that's clueless and loves me because she likes my 50-cent haircuts that I pay $400 for. And I'm going to pay for the kid. You don't love your baby, because if you did, you won't. You know what love is? Castellano's not the best example of love. Castellano's made a million mistakes. And I'll be the first one to say I've made a lot of them. But you know what love is? Love is when you're starving and you got one little bite of food left and everybody's eating and your son or daughter's there and you say, honey, would you like that last bite? And you give it to them. Love is when you see a new sports car or you see a new... I don't know, you want to go on vacation someplace, Super Bowl or something, but your kid would like a new bicycle, or your daughter would like to have a Barbie party. And you know what you do instead of buying a new sports car, middle-aged wonder? You let your daughter have the Barbie party instead. That's what love is. Love isn't me first, like you. Now all of a sudden, I get found innocent. I love my Quentin. You don't love nobody but yourself and them 25-cent haircuts. You goof! I despise you. Who else do I despise? Tom Cruise. The only way he did the Mission Impossible movie. Mr. Phelps, one of the greatest heroes of the Mission Impossible movies, in charge. Mr. Cruise wouldn't have none of that. If I'm going to do a Mission Impossible movie, it's only going to be me. I'm the only star. That's why the Mission Impossible movies suck. Listen, you big-nosed goof, you're a little pencil-neck Melvin, Rock of Ages. Oh, I can't wait to see that. I saw it coming to track. Rock of Ages. You got a nose like an aardvark. I never want to see one of your movies. I think you're a Melvin. Cameron Diaz. Quick, we're talking about guys. Okay, I'm going to sneak a girl in there. Listen, crater face, you and Brad Pitt, you guys got the worst acne and the worst crater faces in Hollywood. You guys are ugly. Alex Rodriguez, I love Madonna. Madonna stinks. She's got a hairy, she's Italian, Castle. She's got hairy, smelly armpits. She's got a space between her teeth you could put a bobsled through. And you know what? She lets smelly dancers hop all over her during her videos and she don't care. So what do I think? I think Hollywood, I despise Hollywood. There's only a few guys like Sneezy, I don't know, Tom Selleck, Magic Johnson. There's very few that I care about in Hollywood. You know what? Why do you think Castellano's in Hollywood? Because I despise the crowd. You Hollywood liberal losers, stay there. Jane Fonda, go over there. You stop the war. War is
bad. The United States is bad. North Korea, South Korea.
What happened, Miss Fonda? You, Martin Luther King, and the rest of you hobos stopped the war, and what happened? 1 million Koreans were killed. Why? Because the United States ran with their tail between legs because the liberal agenda said stop the war. 1 million people. Look it up, folks. Hanoi Jane, this drink isn't for you. It's for me, the Rick Castellano Show, and every week. If you want to hear more of the truth, I'll tell it to you no matter how painful it is. And why am I saying, Rick, you made fun of Martin Luther King? Think he's a great man? But folks, when John McCain was in jail, getting his butt kicked Martin Luther King was talking about how bad the country is. So when McCain got out of getting beat up and it was time to vote for the holiday, yes or no, McCain said no. Now he's a racist. Why? Because while he was in beaten, getting beaten, his butt kicked in prison, Martin Luther King was talking bad about the United States, how much traitors we were. So you know what? He's not all good. So he had a dream. Keep the dream to yourself. I'll tell you when it's good. Smoke 'em! Tonight, Castellano has a lot of things in store, but let's start right off with current events. And who better to start with is one of my favorite distractions? Michelle, let me throw a pig knuckle sandwich in my throat, Obama. This is a lady that tells us we must eat broccoli and arugula and serve smaller portions, right, in schools and at restaurants. But as you can see, she's stuffing down big cheeseburgers, filthy, greasy cheeseburgers down that fat, hideous face. Why am I saying it? Because I believe it. Look it. It's Castellano. Why are you being so mean? Well, I don't know. This white old lady, Paula Deen, says when Michelle was a guest on her show, I'm quoting, folks, she probably ate more than any other guest I've ever had on my show. Take a good look. Castellano doesn't make this stuff. This isn't doctored up. If it was doctored up, I'd probably lose my hand because she ate it. Michelle Obama, keep your opinion to yourself. If you want us to eat good yourself. You interloping pig! That brings us to one of our previous winners, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Excuse me a second. This is a large matter to digest. I'm just doing to get the bad taste out of my mouth. Let me enjoy this part. Much better. Cher, see it? Glamorous picture? That's not who we're going to talk about right now. We're going to talk about Blimpenstein. Chastity. Not Chaz. Chastity Bono. I got to see documentaries. It's how great. She's in love for the first time, and she's dancing in the stars, and she's one of the worst dancers I've ever seen. I don't know, that one rapper was probably worse than her. But anyways, how much a triumph that documentary is. She came forward. She's going to get her something sewn on, and she's going to get something cut off, and she's going to get this and that. Listen, she's going to get injections to grow hair on the side of her face. Why didn't she get more injections to grow hair over her face? But anyways, you, Lenny Dykstra, and the rest of you people wanted to tell me how this was good and how it was a match made in heaven. Not heaven, folks, not heaven. When you say that, believe me, you're in the wrong side of the spectrum. Anyway, could you get a close-up of that, producer, of these pictures of, Chaz? You could see that, sir? Yeah. All right. Anyway, lost my appetite. I saw Sonny. It was a female next to him. What is that? It looks like a linebacker from the Ravens. Yeah. Anyway, isn't that Sue from the Detroit Lions? Anyway, you rammed it down my throat and everybody else's. Well, how great this is, and how this is good, and how the psychologists changed the rule books so you could have your sex change? Well, listen, Chaz, old buddy, whatever you are, whatever you are, I got something for you. I know why your relationship failed. Come to Dear Abby Castellano. I'll tell you why. Because she had to clean your shorts, you filthy pig! Oh, believe me, there's more stripes on there than Napoleon's flag. Chaz, sorry it failed, and sorry you failed miserably. Folks, don't get sex change operations because don't follow in her footsteps. We're back! Excuse me a second. I forgot why I had this, now I remember. Current events, Demi Moore. you may need this to get a little of the Desperate Housewives of New Jersey you got stuck in your teeth? Cheating on Ashton? Oh, they made a big, big deal about it when Ashton cheated on you. You old bag. And what happened? You had your own little fling. Like I said, Desperate Housewife off at a party? You may need this. And you may need a little mouthwash. Speaking of current events, folks, I don't know if any of you have been paying attention lately, but remember, what was it, Paytech? What was the name of it?
Paytech, yeah.
Paytech.
Got their name taken off the field.
Taken off the field down over, down the road, Salahi or whatever, Sally Baba down the road. No longer Paytech. They're going to build a big 30-story building real high.
Yeah.
Then they're going to build it 10 stories. Then they're going to build a... They're just going to tell you a story. Because now, have you been there lately? Big place. Maine and Clinton. Prime place in the city of Rochester. What do we have? We have a parking lot. They're paving it. Yeah, big project, Mr. Mayor. Oh, Mr. Richards. Oh, you got it right there. Oh, a handshake and a Coke and, you know... Yeah. How good did that do? They got bought out, and what do we got? We got nothing.
$80 million worth of teardown.
$80 million. Didn't we borrow some of that money? And you know what? We also talked about it in a past story that, folks, you know, you give an approximate bid. What's going to be? It should take about this much. The union spend every last cent.
Yeah.
You know what? What we get? We got nothing. We got a parking lot.